Hey there. Just getting set up here. Okay. Checking sound. Checking the sound. Do you want to check the sound? Can you open it up and check the sound?
It's not coming up yet.
Okay, just open up on our page and you should go to here.
I have our page, but it's not.
We'll refresh it. Yeah. Refresh it. I think it's working. Okay. We're good. Alrighty. Okay, Sergio, hello. Hey, Martin, Karen, hope you'll stay on. We're just getting started here. Got some fun stuff today. Let me just get a couple things, make sure I'm all set up here. So, alrighty, cool. All right, we're gonna have a little fun of it today. So, welcome everybody. Hope you're enjoying this beautiful day. Kind of cold, but hey, we can't complain, right? The sun's out. So we actually had snow last night. That was really strange for May, but you know. But yeah, we're gonna have a little fun today. Like I said, if you saw, we are going to be, last week I made friends with Daisy. Daisy always wants to be in on it. Okay, this is Daisy. Say hi, Daisy. Okay, she loves music. But I made a new friend in Switzerland last week, and it got me thinking I should definitely... Hey, Sherry. I should definitely do some accordion music this week, so we're going
to
have fun.
You'll need an Apple Music subscription.
I got Siri talking to me. Turn that off. Don't you love technology? Okay, anyways, we're going to have a little fun today. I'm going to start off today. I said we're going to go to the 70s, and I always open my programs with the Music Box Dancer, and it was written in 1974 by Frank Mills. This is a book of Frank Mills' music. He was really famous in the 70s and early 80s. I'm actually going to play about three songs of his, and I'm going to give it the 70s feel. So just imagine we're turning the clock back a little bit, okay? And when he played it, if you've ever listened to the Music Box Dancer, you will know that it did have some drums. So using digital technology, I thought, hey, let's have a little bit of fun. So this is a my rendition of Music Box Dancer 70s style. So. Thank you. hope you enjoyed that. Yeah. So this next song I'm going to do, it's also by Frank Mills. Let me change one setting right here. Oh, sorry. Okay. Now this is a really upbeat song, okay? And it's called Spanish Coffee, okay? So you think Spanish are upbeat and coffee, caffeine, put it together. This was a famous song. It was written in 1973. So anyways, if Titus, if you get to watch this, he's one of my students. He loves this song. Whenever I play this at the restaurant, he's always like, so he learned it. So it's a lot of fun. So again, it's Spanish Coffee by Frank Mills. So we're going to add a beat on this one too. Here we go. Enjoy that too. That's just a lot of fun. I'm gonna do one more by Frank Mills and then we're gonna get the accordion out. I know we said we'd do some accordions, so I got some special songs planned for you. This is a slower song. There's gonna be no drums on this one. But this is called the theme from the Silver Broom, and it's just a really relaxing waltz. I kind of like it. Again, kind of makes you feel in that 70s type.
Thank you.
hope you enjoyed that, taking you back to the 70s. Now let's get some recording out. Let me grab it here. I've got this German accordion. Ah, I got a sip over. Also, let's make it official here. Let's put the fedora on. Ah, over here. Okay. Actually, hey, wait. I think I want to move the camera a little bit. Okay. So we're getting this technology up. All right. Okay. So this is a German Weltmeister accordion, a really nice quality one. It was actually made probably about 40 or 50 years ago, and I actually bought it from Bulgaria, believe it or not. So I'm going to play a song on it and then tell you a couple stories about how I got into the accordion. It's pretty cool, pretty neat God story. This first song I'm going to play kind of as a warm-up. I dedicate to my student, Marilyn. She is learning the piano, but this song has a lot of meaning to her. Shall We Gather at the River? I was going to get my key here. Thanks for joining in. Shall We Gather at the River? Swiss style, a little polka-ish. So the accordion, how did I get into the accordion? Well, about 3 years ago when I started my music studio, as far as teaching goes, my first student was Amish, by the way. It's kind of interesting to me. Chloe, you're my first student. My first student responding from an advertisement was Amish. That's what I meant. Chloe is a, if you're watching, you're my first student. Other than join faith. So my student that took dulcimer for a while, Mary, had two sisters, Christina and Irene. And one day I get a call from Christina. I think she was 18 at the time. And she said, hey, I've heard you can play a lot of instruments, and we have this accordion. Now, this is Old Order Amish, by the way. We have this accordion that my dad got me for my birthday last year, and we were just wondering if you would teach us. And at first, I was like, I don't own an accordion, except for a little squeeze box that I might play another day. But I thought, I was going to say no, and then I know it was the Holy Spirit said, say yes. And I said, okay. So I said yes. I'll get an accordion. So I get off the phone and I go, what have I done? I got this, I've got students for accordion. I don't own an accordion. So I quickly got on Facebook and posted a thing, said, anybody got an old accordion they don't need? You know, let me know. In the meantime, I got on eBay and found this beauty of an accordion, and ordered it all the way from Bulgaria. I got it for about $200, and this would be like Weltmeister is a top maker of accordions. This model they don't make, but a similar one today would be like $1,300-$1,400. So I feel like I got a pretty good deal, and it plays just like new. But anyways, so I bought that, and then I got an email on Facebook from a friend, and she said, we have this elderly lady in our church, or in our prayer group, and she actually has this old accordion, and for months now she's been saying, as a prayer request, she's been saying, pray that this was my dad's accordion. It was an Italian accordion, a big 120 bass, and been praying that God would use this for his glory. And I thought, wow, I've already ordered this accordion, but I can't turn that down. So we all went out and met with her. Her name was Beth. I think she was in her mid-70s. We didn't know she was fighting a terminal illness. But met with her, and she just shared how her dad just played this accordion and, you know, loved the Lord, and she does too, and how she would just hope that it could be used for God's purposes. And I said, well, I've already got this accordion that I really think I'm going to like ordered, but I'm going to take it, and I'll see what happens. So, started teaching Christina and Irene. They had one accordion between them, so they're sisters, and so we would have lessons. I got my accordion, and they would change back and forth their accordions. Well, I told them I got this really nice accordion that was given to me, this Italian accordion. It's a little big for me because I have back problems. So anyways, didn't take long for me to figure out the math there that maybe, and I think I prayed about it, and I think I felt like God said, give them the accordion, you know. Of course, I got this extra accordion. So one night I showed up and I brought the extra accordion, and they didn't know I was going to give it to them. And so I let them try it on, and Christina, she got that thing on, and she's just like, oh, this is so awesome. And so then Irene, her other sister, is like, wow, we can play together. And, you know, about halfway through, I shared, well, your brothers really aren't going to like me now. They said, why? I said, well, you already said that when you play accordion at night, they can't stand it. Now you got two. And then her jaw just dropped, because this was a really nice Italian accordion. I mean, they make good ones in Italy. And I said, yeah, it's yours. And she got very emotional. And she's like, tomorrow's my birthday, and this is like the best gift I've ever been given. And I was like, well, I didn't know that. She's like, yeah, but it was from God, and I'm seeing it from him. So I left the accordion. Next lesson, I came, and her mom came out, and she was very emotional, and she said, Jason, you don't know what this meant. Christina, who I gave to, had been going through a time where she was really doubting God's love for her, and they as a family had been praying that God would do something that would just show his care. And this accordion was the answer to that prayer. And I was really touched. I was like, wow. So when I get home that night, I called Beth, the one that had given the accordion, and I got on the phone with her, and I said, you're going to be amazed how God used this accordion in this young Amish lady's life. And once I told her the story, she started crying, and she said, well, it's my birthday tomorrow, too. And she was, I mean, so two birthdays, and I was just like, oh, call that coincidence, maybe, but just amazing. And Beth actually died like about 4 or 5 months later. And so it was just a really neat thing that God did, and it blessed me, it blessed them. A real testimony of God's care, even over a musical instrument, just an old accordion. And he's used this in the life to show an 18-year-old young Amish lady that is struggling in her faith that God loves her. And so I hope that story would encourage you today, that God loves you. He is faithful in these times. So I just wanted to share that. The next song I'm going to play is the first song I learned on the accordion, which is a Czech song. And it's just called Sirotic. I don't know what that means, but I like it. And I think it's a pretty song. So I'm going to play it for you. This is the first song I learned. That. But yeah, I thought that was a really cool song. Again, that's from the Czech. Next song I'm going to play is a standard that many of you will recognize, Chopsticks. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, I'm going to play a variation on it, have a little bit of fun. Chopsticks. All right. Now let's move on to a Swiss song. I don't know if my new Swiss friend is watching, but this has got to be one of the most famous polkas of all time. It's called The Happy Wanderer. And you imagine a Swiss, the Switzerland and the great mountains. and I forget the words to it, but the Happy Wanderer, and it's just about a jolly man just enjoying the creation of God. But I think you'll recognize this. Once I get in the right key, I gotta do that. Okay, sorry about that. Thank you for joining in, Sherry. Yes, okay. Glad you're enjoying the accordion. Let's do another polka. Polka. Okay, I like polkas. They're fun, okay? This is a German polka. The Schwarzwalde. I know a little bit of German. Ich spreche ein bisschen Deutsch. Not very much. But I am studying Hebrew right now. Ani lome di vrit. I don't know if my friends or Sergio is watching, but I'm working on it. But anyways, this is a German, it's called the Schwarzwalde or the Black Forest Waltz. And it's a fun little song. It's one of the harder songs, so I may blow it a few times, but hey, maybe I won't. Okay. They get you. Hope you enjoyed that. That was called the Black Forest Waltz. And hey, I make mistakes. We all do. So you keep playing. I'm going to do another song now. This is a famous Israeli song and probably one of the, it's well known around the world. Titus, if you're watching, you're going to like this one. You know where I'm going. Hava Nagila. Hava Nagila. So. Gotta get in the right key. Song. I remember when we went to Israel in 2009, anytime there was a piano or something, I would sit down and play that, and you'd always get people coming in and join in. I'm going to do another song on the accordion for you. This is a waltz, and my own version of Redeemed. Redeemed, how I love to proclaim it. Redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Okay, so you know that song? This is my own version of it.
Thank you.
enjoyed the accordion. I'm going to have my wife and daughter, Joy, come down soon. Is that the cue? Do I hear their footsteps? Or do I need to play another song? Okay, maybe I'll have to play something else. I think they're coming. Let's make something up. Song that just came off the top of the fedora. Is that what they call these? Yeah. Okay. Anyways, cool. I hope you enjoy that. We might bring the accordion back another time. I actually have a different type of accordion called a button box that I did not bring out today, but that has also some unique sounds on it. And I like to play like the chicken waltz on that one and stuff like that. So we might have some fun with that. But anyways, I think Joy and Jenny are coming in. And I'm going to part with the accordion. Hey, Joy, how are you today?
Okay.
How's that school going?
Okay. Lots of brain work.
For those of you who were here last week, we explained that Joy is a college student and started online college. And she's getting straight A's and doing an awesome job. And I'm going to move this over here till we get her in too, so we all are in, hopefully. Okay.
Hello, everyone.
Hey, everybody. We're just gonna sing a couple songs that we like to sing well enough that we have them memorized.
They're scripture songs.
Yeah, scripture songs. And do you want to share anything about them since my voice
is going a little bit? Allergies.
For it. Okay.
Which one do you want to sing first?
Behold, God is my salvation.
Okay.
Well, this is a Jewish flavored song, actually, Israeli, I guess you'd say. But Jenny, if you want to share from Isaiah 12.
Sure. This song is just straight scripture from Isaiah 12, verse 2. It says, "Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. For Yah the Lord is my strength and my song, and he also has become my salvation."
So Sergio and Rhoda, if you're watching this, join along. You may know this one.
Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and will not be afraid. For the Lord my God is my strength and my song. He also has become my salvation. For the Lord my God is my strength and my song. He also has become my Yeshua. La 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 la. I will trust and will not be afraid. For the Lord my God is my strength and my song. He also has become my salvation. For the Lord my God is my strength and my song. He also has become my Yeshua. La 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 la.
La 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 you don't know, the word Yeshua is, that's Hebrew for Jesus or salvation. And it's so cool that the name Jesus means, Yeshua means salvation. And so the very name of Jesus means salvation. So the name above all names. What's the next song we're doing, honey? She keeps me in line. Can you tell that?
Okay. We can do, you want to do Proverbs 3, 5, and 6?
Yes. Okay. Yes, good idea. Okay, this is a song I actually
put music to.
I really didn't write it because it's straight from the Bible. Well, no, we did write the chorus parts, okay?
Yeah, we did.
But yeah. One of our life verses is Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. And trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your paths. And if you study a little bit of Hebrew, that word acknowledge doesn't just mean to acknowledge him, but it also means to seek him, to seek to know him. And I think sometimes we get things mixed up. I think we sometimes think, hey, God, I just want you to show me what to do. Give me the answer. Tell me which way to go. And I think sometimes what God's saying is that I just want you to seek me. And if you just seek me, I'll guide you. You may not know how, but I will. And we've seen this countless times in our life. We've seen it this past week in a situation I won't go into. God was faithful in a tough situation. Not as tough as what many people are going through, but for us it was tough. But we all got our struggles. So, but anyways,
trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him. He will direct your path. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him. He will direct your path. I know that he is risen. I know my Redeemer lives. I know that he is risen, coming back again. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him. He will direct your path. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him. He will direct your path. Trust in the mighty sovereign Lord of heaven and of all the earth. Trust in his great salvation for all of those who trust. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him. He will direct your path.
Try as you want.
Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him. He will direct your path. Good
word. I got off there on that one verse, but we kept going.
Yeah,
you keep singing, you know? I tell a lot of my music students, they're so afraid to make mistakes. And I'm like, we all make mistakes, not just musically, but everywhere in life. The difference is, though, do you keep going? If you do fall down, if you do mess up, do you just keep on going? The worst thing you can do is just stop, you know? And I think in life, there are so many parallels to that. You know, we all hit these walls at times where we just feel like we can't go on, and maybe we can't. But we hit that down, and if we look up, God gives us the grace, and we can get back up and keep going. So, we're going to do one more. What was that? Oh, okay, yes.
That was, sir.
A friend of ours, Tim and Pam, I don't know if you're watching, but Tim Wilson wrote this song. Well, he didn't write the song. It's based entirely on Scripture, but he wrote the medley to it. I think he wrote it for his kids, and it's a favorite of ours. It's Philippians 4:8, and it's, finally, brethren, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of good report, if there is anything of virtue, and if there's anything praiseworthy, meditate upon these things. Philippians 4, verse 8. And this verse has been so powerful in my life. I actually have it on my computer monitor. I have it written above my monitor because there's, in the internet age, there's so many temptations. And we're all tempted at times to think thoughts that maybe are impure, or not just about, you know, in the realm of, you know, where I'm going, but also just any time you're just thinking negative thoughts, or just, you know, thoughts that just kind of bring you down. And a lot of times the Holy Spirit will just bring this verse to my mind and just redirect my thoughts. You know, think on things that are true, noble, right? Which, of course, all comes back to Jesus.
Finally, brethren, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of good report, there is anything of virtue, there is anything praiseworthy, meditate upon these things. Philippians 4, verse 8. Finally, brethren, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of good report, if there is anything of virtue, if there's anything praiseworthy, meditate upon these things. Philippians 4, verse 8.
All right, hope you enjoyed that. It's a really good song. Tim, if you get to watch this, Tim and Pam, dear friends of ours, go way back, we love them dearly. So that song has been a favorite of ours in our family. Was there any other songs that we were singing, honey?
I think that was the three.
Okay, I think that was the three. They'll be back.
We have
okay.
A little bit of allergies
yeah.
today.
So. Yeah, that's excuse. Okay, yes, you know, spring. Yeah. But yeah, we got more songs coming. Joy says that we're going to keep doing this, like I said, for right now. And what did you say?
No, once you're done with school.
Yes.
What did Joy say? Let me tell you what Joy said. Tell you everything she said. Not okay. But what did you say?
That when I'm done with school, that I'll be doing some stuff. On
yeah.
Here.
Yeah.
We might even get her in here to do a solo song or something like that. So stay tuned. Yeah. But she's got another week or so, and then
yeah. Then I'm done.
And you can think again. Well,
yeah.
She has been thinking, but
yeah, I've been hyper thinking.
Hyper thinking. But anyways, thanks for joining, honey.
Thanks for having us.
Enjoy. So now I'm going to turn back to the piano. All right.
Nice.
Hope you enjoyed that.
Everyone.
Let me flip this back here. There we go. Now you notice the tie, right? Whoops. Okay. This is a real bow tie, by the way. See, I don't wear fake bow ties. I'm a snob. Actually, I was at a gig once, at a wonderful place called the Pine Tree Barn, and at that time I was just wearing the clip-on, or the ones that just kind of clip around and they're pre-tied, and I thought that was pretty cool. And this older man came up to me in a tuxedo, because this is a really fancy dinner. And he had a really nice, real bow tie on. I could tell it was real because it was like polka dotted and it was kind of off skewed. And I was like, that's a real tie. He really tied that. And I remember I said, yeah, hey, nice bow tie. And he looked at me and he said, And I remember just the body language was like, oh, I'm being snubbed. I don't have a real bow tie. So after that, I thought, man, I better learn how to tie real bow ties. And got on YouTube, good old YouTube, and you look it up, how to tie a bow tie, and they got tons of videos of guys going. Well, over time, I learned too, and so now all I wear is real tied bow ties. And I am now a bow tie snob. In fact, one time I was at an orchestra, and in the men's bathroom, I saw one of the orchestra members in a tuxedo, and he had one of the fake bow ties, and I had to resist the urge just to say, why don't you tie your own? Oh, come on. It's not that important. So, anyways. So, with this bow tie on, I have to play. I mean, Charlie Brown wouldn't let me get away with it, and neither would Snoopy. So I have to play Charlie Brown. I'm so happy. What's that? You want me to play something more? What? Oh, okay. Yep. Won't ever let me off the hook, you know, because, you know, there's other songs by Vince Guaraldi than just the Charlie Brown theme. So Snoopy just reminded me of that. So yeah, what should we play, Snoopy? Oh, that's the one you want. Okay, let me see if I can find it. I think it's back here. That's a hard one though. Are you sure? Okay, this one's called Red Baron. This was one of his favorites. Oh, Charlie Brown, you're good too.
Thank you.
enjoyed that. That was called The Red Baron by Vince Guaraldi. He wrote a lot of interesting music. The next one I'm going to do is actually a slower tune of his. I kind of like it. It's called Air Music. And it's kind of, I'm going to add some strings here. And just kind of a little bit more relaxed Charlie Brown. Charlie Brown for you. I promised I'd play this next song for one of my students. He was trying to learn this. Everybody knows this. What's that from? Heart and Soul. Okay, that's the famous duet that all kids learn. So. You know, they usually play it separate hands, so we'll put it together. Enjoy that Heart and Soul. Hey, thank you. Hey, Charlie. Hey, Matt. Hey, good to see you, old friend. Matt from, if you're joining, Matt, I know your son's interested in accordion. I played about 7 or 8 songs, and if you missed it, it will be up. I always leave these videos up on the Facebook, and then I also put them on my YouTube channel. I have a YouTube channel, Jason Fox Music Studio. If you're interested, check it out and subscribe. I might start doing some more on that eventually. The other song I had promised to play for one of my students, Beth. I don't know Beth Migiani, if you're watching, but she's been working on this song. And this is actually, if you've watched the movie Ben-Hur, based on the famous book, this is the story. It's from the time of Christ. It's an awesome movie and book. Many of you have probably watched it. But this is from the movie. This is the, now it's not Christmas, but hey, it's always Christmas, right? Star of Bethlehem, this is the theme from when the wise men came. By the way, mentioning that, I didn't even think of this, but our friends Sergio and Rhoda recently came out with a YouTube video. You can check out Sergio and Rhoda. That's S-E-R-G-I-O and R-H-O-D-A. Just look that up on YouTube. They have the coolest Israeli, or they do all these like videos of Israel, and they're both from Nazareth. They know Yeshua, Jesus, and they do an awesome job. But they just came out with a video this last week, which was really interesting, and it was, I can't even say it right, but the Nabataeans, I guess, which was an ancient civilization that kind of came into being, Petra, and it kind of ceased. I don't remember all the dates, but the long story short was, if you watch this video on it, it just came out, was that maybe the wise men came from Nabatea, and that's based on the Bible. I may have gotten some of the details wrong. But anyway, so this song is the scene where the wise men come, and they see the star, and they follow it to the baby Jesus. So I'm going to add some strings in. That that really does kind of encapsulate. Hey, thank you. I love that song. I love that movie. That's one of our favorite family movies we watch. the story of Judah Ben-Hur. It's just an awesome story. If you haven't seen the movie, and most of you probably have, I definitely highly recommend it. Another song I promised a student, I told them I will do this all the time. If they have it, I gotta grab my music here. So Matthias, if you get to watch this, I think that's who it was for. Yeah, I've had a lot of students I've taught this to. But I can't even say it. Guantanamera. I guess it's a Spanish place. But this is kind of a fun song. Song. And speaking of Spanish, I don't know if I played this once before in one of my past concerts, but who cares if I did? This is like my fifth concert, so can't you repeat songs after five concerts? Okay, anyways, Spanish Eyes. Okay, ooh, my grandmother, mom, if you're watching this, you'll appreciate this, grandmommy, she went to be with the Lord last year. We miss her dearly. But we know that she is with Jesus. But she liked this guy named Engelbert Humperdinck. Don't you just love that name? Anybody know who Engelbert Humperdinck is? Well, I don't think that's his real name, but he was famous for this song, Spanish Eyes. If you get a chance and you want to look up something from like the 60s, look up Spanish Eyes by Engelbert Humperdinck. And I probably said his name totally wrong. But he was a famous, singer. And she loved him. So I'll play that in honor of her, but Spanish Eyes. Thank you. Franchise. Hope you like Spanish music. I feel like doing another Spanish song. I don't know why, but I just do. If I can find it, that's always the problem with me. I know it's in here, though. Don't you love when you get an idea and you can't, don't know. This was not planned, so. I just kind of go spontaneous, you know. So, and it's hiding, of course. Well, maybe not. Okay, that's enough Spanish. Okay, I'm going to play. Okay, I'm going to play. This is a song. Do you all remember Five-O Goes West, An American Tale? The little story with the mouse. And I like that. That was a favorite story. Humperdinck was born. Arnold George Dorsey, he is still with us and is 84. Hey, thanks, Jeff. He was on the radio and TV all the time, and I can't read the rest, but yeah, so that was just his stage name. So thanks, Jeff. Jeff is a neighbor and a friend, and this guy is able to research stuff really good. So he's always on Facebook giving us a lot of information about what's going on, and helped us a lot even in this time. So thank you, Jeff. But anyways, this is Somewhere Out There from American Tale. Just remember the little mouse. So, thank you. if you remember that song, but yeah, brings back some memories for me. How beautiful heaven must be, thinking back what I just mentioned about my grandmother and what she is experiencing right now. And this song happens to be right here, and I didn't plan it, but I think I'm going to play it. It's a hymn called How Beautiful Heaven Must Be. Thanks for joining in. How beautiful heaven must be. I played some before from The Sound of Music, and this is one I didn't play a month ago. But I always liked that. That's probably I have really good fond memories as a kid. We used to watch that a lot, Mom. You're watching right now, and Dad. I don't know how many times I've seen that movie, but it's just such a good movie. And, you know, the Sound of Music, and it's got such a great story line, and it's based on a true story, too, which is pretty cool, the Von Trapp family. And the music is amazing. The good old Rodgers and Hammerstein, they sure know how to write music, didn't they? One of my favorite scenes in the movie is... you know, when she's having her doubts, when she comes back to the Abbey, and she's, I forget what the matriarch or the main nun's name was. But anyway, so she sings this song, Climb Every Mountain, and such a beautiful song. Let me change the setting here. And, just a second. Good. Okay. So, take yourself to that scene.
Thank you.
Let's just go back to good old speakers. Am I back now? Okay. Thank you for my wife monitoring. I got this new system I've been working in, and I just realized that this thing, the batteries don't last forever, so from now on I need to probably power this too. I was running this on batteries, and the batteries obviously gave out. This is it's called the Tascam DP-008, and Sergio, my friend, helped me get this set up. Still having some technical issues, but batteries are one of them. But it has really good mics. For those of you who have my Hymns on a Steinway CD, I actually recorded it with this. It has these built-in condenser mics right here. And I literally, this was in 2012, I literally set it inside the frame of a Steinway grand piano that I was playing on, and literally set it on the frame of the piano inside of it. And so those of you who have my CD, Hymns on a Steinway, have heard it. You're actually hearing the sound of a Steinway from inside the piano. So it's pretty cool. So thankfully, though, I unplugged. So now we're almost done anyways. But now we're on iPad audio, which is better than nothing. So, and this will be cool because I'll be able to see, when I listen, I'll be able to see what this sounds like versus the iPad. So, hey, it all works out for good, right? So I'm just going to end with a couple songs here. And let's see. What do I feel led to play? I think I had this requested once, Because He Lives. Joining today. I hope you enjoyed our program. Every week's gonna be different. Like next week, what instrument should we do? I've got 20 to choose from, so maybe cast your vote at the bottom there. Actually, I've got an idea. I'll give you a hint. Just think flowers around your neck. I don't know. I might give you a hint. Anybody know what that is? Think maybe island in the middle of the sea. Anybody? Mom's clapping. What is it? What instrument am I thinking of? See who's paying attention. Gave two hints there. It's a small instrument, has only four strings, named after a jumping flea. I'm not making that up. Anybody typing it in? All right. Hey, Diane. Yep. Anyways, ukulele. Yep. I'm thinking next week we're going to do a little bit of singing with the uke. And yep. That'll be fun. And it does mean jumping flea. That's what the word ukulele means. So next week, we're going to do, of course, piano and singing, but have a little fun with the uke. All right. So you all have a great week. Thanks for joining in, and may God bless you all. I hope you're all encouraged. Just to keep looking up. All right. God bless.